gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to the Today I, Mistilda, will be telling you the story of James Marshall and the Circus Phantom. Now, before I tell my story, let me formally introduce myself. My name is Mistilda, and I don't really know what I have to do with the circus, but I'm good. Now, without further ado, let's start the show.
Thank you.
down, everyone. Everything's going to be just fine. I don't think anybody got hurt too seriously.
Pop and Hilda!
Thank goodness this is only a rehearsal.
Yeah, we've got to figure this out. This is the fifth accident we've had in the last month.
Did anybody see what happened?
through the first act of our circus extravaganza when we had the accident.
It was no accident, I say again. It was the Circus Phantom. Will you stop doing that?
The Circus Phantom, you say. Can you tell me a little more about that?
Yes, it was a dark and stormy night. The rain fell in torrents in the attic.
Enough already, Miss Wilbur. No one wants to hear jabbering on about some highfalutin tall tale of yours. All that phantom and his mumbo jumbo is boring the opposite.
So, we got some respectable law in the sky here from the big city. Nice to meet you, Detective. The name's Devin McNally. I'm a sideshow here at the circus. Over there, we've got Seamus and Hamus, Madam Millie LeBeau. She's a fortune teller. Strong man Bjorn, Jorn, Jorgensen. Leona Dunoff, Francesca, and her man Antonio Felipe Pastrami. They do flips and twists. Hoagie, the tattoo person, finally, Millie, the contortionist and juggler, Mike Mediocre.
He's not very good.
Don't throw questions up in him. He's red sensitive. Hey, Mike, you did a great job with him. We're all rebounding, son.
Thanks, guys. If he's not that good, why do you have him?
He's the best we can afford.
Anywho, never say see nothing. We sure don't want to end up like poor old Brunhilde over there.
Bless her soul. Hey, boss, look at this handkerchief.
Ooh! What if I disguise myself as one of the trapeze assistants?
Nobody wants to see you flying through the air, Basilda.
Well, anyways, that James Marshall, he's not his friend. His sidekick, however, that's a different story altogether. Johnston is very perceptive.
Wait, Johnston knows too much. We've got to get them apart.
Precisely, Lushy. I like the way you think. One more month and I'll be out of this circus and onto my real passion.
But I thought you were born for this.
Don't be so naive. I wasn't born for this. I was born to be something more. To work above my station. To work with numbers and equations. I was born to be more of a circus performer and I know it. My calling is off the stage, behind the floodlights, out of the way of applause. Sometimes I just want to run away from the circus and join a family. And then I can finally fulfill my true passion.
And what would that be, mister?
I want to be an insurance adjuster.
An insurance adjuster?
What is that?
I want to work in an office and have a briefcase. A beautiful brown briefcase made of imitation patent leather.
And a calculator. One that gleams in a reflection of fluorescent lights. And spreadsheets. So many spreadsheets. Formulas, equations, government regulations, sex of free 07B forms. Really, who would all work in a circus and you can spend your entire day in your cubicle, poring over government regulations and insurance forms? Yeah. That's the life for me. So, what's our next plan? Come with me, my fine feathered friend.
So,
the caterpillar started to sprout its wings and turn into a delicious butterfly. I knew this day would come.
Okay, wise boys. No more good for now. We've got to get this act ready to go, and yeah, I'd like a bunch of that.
But we is clowns.
Oh, we are more. Mamma mia, what shall we do?
I agree. This has to make it impossible for us to work here. You know at the Madison Appleton Circus Extraordinaire? They have a union. You should start one of those.
A union? No, I'm not talking about these silly clowns. They don't make plays with laughing and joking around. So not to make me a sick.
Morning, folks. Can you tell us anything about the handkerchief?
Whoa there, Johnston. A little quick on the questioning. My name is James Marshall. You know, you may know me from such headlines as the Great Asper Diamond Theft of 1932, the Coconut Keeper, the Mommy's Curse of 1944, and more.
This man is quite fond of himself.
I see, Newmark. He likes to, as the Americans say, blow the horn.
Say something, miss?
Oh, no. What can we help you with, detective?
Yeah, detective. How can we help with this phantom of the fashion business going on in this city?
Will you stop running around back there? I'm talking here. Jeez. Lock up. Detective!
Sorry. I was, sorry.
It's okay, James. I got this. Antonio, were you able to see the incident from above?
Unfortunately not, you see. We're always up in the rafters.
And it's really difficult to see up there, Detective, but right next to us.
If all the missteps have been occurring, we're mainly focused on our safety.
Of course, but that's too bad. Bubbles, muffles, tumbles, anything bad?
Don't pay attention to those two wise guys. They don't even know if they have weakness. Sorry, Detective, I haven't noticed anything either.
Oh, quick whips. Even though I can't see much, I did have to notice that
The what?
The magicians, Mr. E, and his assistants, Mr. Reaction, who's leading, and Miss Harris, reacting very suspiciously the last few days.
Almost like they were trying to hide a secret or something. Sorry, Detective, we've got to get back to working on our routine full time.
Us too, no more playing around.
Thank you.
dangerous that our insurance regulators only allow us to perform it once per month.
Luckily, you came on the right night. We are proud to present the Mystifying Sword through Revolution.
Not be attempted by anyone under any circumstance.
Do not try this at home. Mr. Rector, if you please. Miss Sirius, will you please pass the sword through the safety collar to show that it does indeed penetrate all the way through the middle? Good job. Now, Miss Weedon, will you please show that the sword is in fact solid and does not collapse into the sword? Now, Miss Sirius, will you please place the safety collar around Miss Direction's neck? Miss Direction, it's very important that you do not move your head one way or the other. Miss Beating, will you please hold the safety collar in place? Now finally, Miss Sirius, will you please put the tip of the sword into the safety collar slowly but firmly? But if you feel any resistance, please stop.
Any resistance? Miss Direction, do you feel the sword?
Yes, I feel on the back of my neck.
And that's because I didn't say the magic words. And when I say the magic word, you can push the tip of the sword into the safety collar. Ecco, storia, mento, sorben!
Thank you. doing the show.
A smorgasbord of briefcases, twisty, turny, twirly,
It was fun to show.
I liked it.
Me too.
Whoa, look at this mess. I didn't like this. I was in Myrtle Beach.
What could have made such a mess?
Yeah, it's the cleaning the boing and the dink the best in my hometown, York, the Sweden.
Oh, so much fun. The messy, very, very messy.
Let's go back. tomato, and I say tomato, but I say potato.
I say potato.
I pronounce a jiff like the peanut butter.
I pronounce a jiff like the way everyone else in the world does. Also, I like peanut butter and jelly sandwiches.
Well, I like peanut butter and jam sandwiches.
I say on.
And I say in. I have great manners.
Well, I practice excellent etiquette. I never went to college.
And I'll certainly never make it into university. My favorite bird is crow.
My favorite bird is a raven. And my favorite sea mammal is a dolphin.
And mine is porpoise.
Hey, did you do that on porpoise?
No, but you know who is 5,000 pounds and lives in the circus?
That's irrelevant.
You're right. There's a whole lot of elephants that live in the circus.
Okay, we should stop this before this becomes way too silly.
Childish.
Nonsensical.
Brainless.
Empty-headed.
Featherbrained.
Foolhardy.
Immature.
Meaningless.
Nitwitted.
Shitheaded.
Simple-minded.
Ninny-hammered.
Dunderheaded.
Addle-padded.
Cogswallow. It's the same, but different.
Kevin, the animal tamer who really left at the train station was there to hook the
No, I better go across from the dinosaur cave more. We have to look back at the train station and hold them.
Good news. I've been joking. So I have my contortionist act.
We have to left the train station and love it for.
Or with the ventriloquist, you left on the train station in Connecticut.
You fools! But that would tell you who it is!
That's a silly thing to say. All we have to do is take off the mask.
Oh, I never thought of that.
Yes! Let's unmask this foul fiend, this conniving Conover, this pustulant pumpernickel persona non grata. Detective James Marshall, remove the mask! Gwendolyn? Is it really you?
Yes, it's me. I admit it. I'm Circus Phantom.
This is a betrayal of grandiloquent proportions.
Because I don't want this circus.
What?
But why? You had it all here. Clowns, acrobats, Great Midwest, Trout, and Mid-Sass City from Fort Wayne to Springfield.
That's what I've been trying to tell you all. This circus is all J.T. Zimmerman's dream, not mine. That's why I became the Circus Santa.
Okay, sounds good. Thanks. Let's Detective James Marshall ending theme song. Let's
Vegas style outro. Okay, looks good. Everyone ready for the big outro?
Yeah.